session of the India Mobile Congress. I must confess that when I was first invited to participate in this meeting, I asked myself as to what society I would be able to contribute. And then the answer came to me in terms of the facts of the various flagship missions that are anchored in my ministry. And I mean not only the smart cities mission, which is anchored in technology, but all the rest that we are doing in terms of the urban rejuvenation that we are attempting in order to build the India of tomorrow. All that requires the use of technology. And I must say, to my long list of actions that required to be taken, I was very touched when one of the writers of industry mentioned what the urban development ministry may do in terms of the location of power. Yes, that is a problem that has confronted us. It is a problem not of our country. When there was a rapid exponential growth in this sector, all service providers wanted towers, and all citizens wanted those towers not to be located in their areas. So clearly, we need to be able to factor that into our urban plan, so that the consumer is not disadvantaged, the service provider is not disadvantaged, and at the same time, the overall objectives that we are trying to achieve are also facilitated. Let me try and outline for you, in the limited time that I have, what precisely the urban rejuvenation is. When we became an independent country in 1947, 17% of India lived in urban spaces. But that was 17% on a population base of only 350 million. Today, as per the latest census, the 2011 census, 30% of India lives in urban spaces, and that is 30% on a population base of 1.25 billion. And we are working towards 2030, when roughly 600 million Indians will live in urban spaces. And the urban space that we have to create requires the building of something like 700 to 900 million square meters of urban space every year. But that has to be built in a green and resilient manner, and that cannot be done without the use of modern technologies. This amounts to building something like one Chicago every year now and 2030 in India. When my ministry unveiled its smart cities vision, one of the flagship programs of the Honorable Prime Minister on June 25, 2015, it selected 100 smart cities. But let me clarify that out of these 190 are brownfield projects. That is, you take an existing city and you try and retrofit it and network development. Only 10 of them are greenfield projects where, as it were, a new smart city can descend to science fiction from the heaven. And retrofitting a brownfield city is always infinitely more difficult than building a new plant. I will have to inform you that this scheme, which is building on technology and innovation, also has a strong element of citizen participation. The smart city mission envisioned a holistic approach to the development of a smart city with emphasis on affordable housing, integrated, unified, multimodal transport, smart security, creation and preservation of open spaces, faster connectivity, remote management of houses, e-transport, connected cars, waste-to-waste traffic management, solar parks, smart lighting, and logistics, among others. For those of you who are visiting India for the first time, and if you have a little time on your hands, I would suggest that you visit one of these smart cities where the integrated command and control centers are fully operational. There are 11 of those. 27 more are under construction, and by this time next year, I'm hoping that there are 50 integrated command and control centers in the